Do you remember this?
Your hit parade. The top tunes all over America, as determined by your hit parade survey, which checks the best sellers in sheet music and phonograph records. The songs most heard on the air, and the songs most played on the automatic coin machine. An accurate, authentic tabulation of America's taste in popular music. Your Hit Parade.
Down yonder, someone beckons to me. Someone reckons on me.
I seem to see a race in memory between the Natchez and the Robert E. Lee.
Swanee Shore, I miss you more and more every day, my mammy land. You're simply grand.
Wake the town and tell the people. Sing it to the moon above. Wake the town. That we're so in love.
Oh, who's sorry now? Sorry now? Whose heart is aching?
Coming, their sails are in sight. Trim boats is coming, they're dancing tonight. Why don't you hurry, hurry, hurry home? Why don't you hurry, hurry, hurry home? Look here, the shrimp boats is a coming, they're dancing tonight. Shrimp boats is a coming, they're dancing tonight.
Years ago, your hit parade was born, and this year marks the 25th anniversary of its first appearance on television. From 1935 to 1959, for almost a quarter of a century in radio and television, your hit parade presented songs that were popular from Maine to California in a thousand different ways. The cast was delightful, the music was singable and danceable, and the lyrics were understandable. And the songs were vocally and visually portrayed in a tasteful, attractive setting. During its lifetime, the greatest galaxy of stars in the history of music performed on Your Hit Parade. Frank Sinatra, Fred Astaire, Kate Smith, Dinah Shore, Ethel Merman, Lawrence Melchior, Dick Powell, the Andrews Sisters, Harry James, Tommy Dorsey, and the list is endless. So tonight, we welcome you to a reunion celebration of one of the finest musical TV shows that ever graced the airwaves. A salute to the best years of your hit parade. Tonight's guest stars in person are...
Oh, Lordy. Oh, e cantare. Oh, oh, oh,
try to tell us. It was fascination, I know, and it might have ended right there at the start.
Waltzing with my darling to the Tennessee waltz, when an old friend I happen to see.
Because of you, there's a song in my heart. Because of you, my romance had its start.
Mr. Sandman, give him two lips like roses in glow. Then tell him that his lonesome nights are over. And how much love you win. The one waggly tail. How much is that doggy in the window? I do hope that doggy's for sale.
Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. I don't want no other love. Baby, it's only you I'm thinking of.
Let's say hello to Snooky and Lanson.
Thank
you for being with us. Richard, it's nice to be here. Hey, looking forward. Look at that. Ah, a sitting ovation. How very nice. Nice they remember you. Isn't that exciting?
It certainly is.
Where did you get that name?
As I'm told, there was a song in the late teens that Irving Berlin wrote called All Night Long They Call Me Snooky Ookums.
Then there was just a nickname then?
That was
that your mom gave you? That's not your real name.
No,
is your real name?
Real name is Roy.
Roy, anything else?
Sailor.
Uh-huh.
S-A-I-L-E-R.
Sailor.
S-A-I-L-E-R. That's the
your
doctor
mom?
That delivered me.
Was his name Sailor?
His name was Sailor Anderson.
And your mom just named you after a doctor?
After him. Well, you know, that was a thing in those days. Maybe you name after the doctor, he'll deliver you cheaper.
Luckily, you weren't delivered by the Mormon Tabernacle Choir. Now, you sang how many songs on a show?
Well, it was two to three, you know, according to, if you did a duet like with Eileen or Dorothy or June.
Yeah.
Just
did they have cue cards for the words?
Oh, no, we didn't have any cue cards.
Did you have to learn all the songs?
You learned as many as you could, and then you wrote lyrics in your hand, in your hat, on the wall, on the floor, anywhere that you could.
Was that not dangerous any time?
Well, it was very dangerous because several times you'd write them on the floor and right before the show, mop that floor up and then once you lived.
But the show was live, so what would you do?
Well, you just did the best that you could.
So sometimes you would sing incorrect lyrics?
Oh, many times.
Well, many times?
Many times.
Well, because now you can talk freely because you're up. But...
And we did commercials.
Live commercials?
We did live commercials and they were not right.
See, the reason I ask you, I was not in the country when...
You probably weren't even born then.
Oh, yes, I did.
Small child?
What a sweet man. Will you stay for the whole 90 minutes? No, when I came in 1962, you see, in Hit Parade was
mm-hmm.
finished then.
That's right.
But I know what a part of an institution. Now, we had Hit Parade in England.
Yes, I
have. And I should have known that they'd stolen the idea because in England it was called Their Hit Parade.
Their Hit Parade.
Of course, like a fool, I had no idea what they meant by that. They obviously were taking all of your ideas. Sing a song for us now.
I'd love to sing. I certainly would.
Pop over to that white piano while I tell them all about the song you're going to sing. The song is the Tennessee Waltz, and it was on the show for 13 weeks and was number one 6 times. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Snooky Lanson.
Waltzing with my darling to the Tennessee Waltz when an old friend I happened to see. I introduced him to my loved one, and while they were waltzing, my friend stole my sweetheart from me. I remember the night and the Tennessee Waltz. Now I know just how much I've lost. Yes, I lost my little darling the night they were playing the beautiful
Let me move my...
That's yours.
All the little notes about the good things. Listen, you had no cue cards.
No, didn't have to have one on that because I sang it so many times.
Was
that exciting?
Did he do a turn?
Yes.
Did he do a turn?
He is one of the great turners of our time.
Oh, yes. Really, I mean, that's his real famous thing.
We'll have to do that.
Now, did you start together on Hit Parade?
Yes. Well, I started actually on radio here with Frank Sinatra.
Really?
And then Frank, I did the show here for about 6 months, and then Frank didn't go back to New York. They wanted to take the show back to New York. They wanted to start it with on television. And so they asked me if I'd go back, and I said...
Now, I know you're married now,
yes,
and your husband's here. I don't wish
yes.
to embarrass you.
No.
Did you ever go out with Frank?
No. I would have liked it, though.
Fancy. I thought he was a classy guy.
Well, you know, there were younger girls around, I guess.
I guess so.
I don't. But it was a thrill because he was my idol in growing up.
Now you had the big voice on the show, right?
You kind of, yeah, next to Snooky.
Oh, no.
Yeah, we kind of both sort of belted things out.
But that's good, though. You got the big song. Favorite song?
No, we had to do all the songs.
Yeah, but was there one that you really loved, you felt was...
The best?
Yeah.
Gee, I don't know. Yeah.
Here's one we thought that you might remember. Watch.
Oh, okay.
something about you now, and something that I think is very, very special. And that's what you're doing right at this moment.
Right at now, I'm a school teacher.
Isn't that nice?
I teach at Pinecrest, and I have, it's a private school out in the valley. We have seven schools, and I'm the in charge of music. And I have from kindergarten to sixth grade. And I have about 500 children.
I happen to think some of the most special people in the world are the people that care enough to teach children. And so
right.
I thank you for doing it.
You will. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Would you sing a song for us, my love?
Yes,
would you
I'd
pop
love.
Over there?
Oh, anyway.
The song is Bewitched, Bothered, and Bewildered on the show, I believe, for 16 weeks. Mm-hmm. Number one for five times. The pretty lady who's going to sing it, Eileen Wilson.
A fool can have his charms. I'm in love and don't I show it like a babe in arms. Love's the same old sad sensation. Lately I've not slept a wink since this half-pint imitation put me on the blink. I'm wild again, beguiled again. Simpering, whimpering child again. Bewitched, bothered, and bewildered am I. Wouldn't sleep unless I could sleep where I shouldn't sleep. Bewitched, bothered, and bewildered am I. Lost my heart, but what of it?
More of your hit parade stars, including Giselle, McKenzie, and Dorothy. Brought back nice memories for me because the first time I ever had the pleasure of seeing you, you were with the marvelous giant talent, Mr. Jack Benny. You were both starring at the London Palladium.
Right.
And I think that really made me want to be somebody. And here we are together. Well, we've been together before.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing gaudy, just a bar. But that night you sang and you made us... Oh, you just made us all feel so good. Would you sing tonight for us?
Oh, I'd love to. Would you do? I'd love to.
It's Giselle McKenzie.
But open your angel arms to this stranger in paradise and tell her that she need be a stranger no more.
Now, in this next number on the hit parade, I was a teenager. It was a little difficult now, but I was only 12 at the time. Mr. Sandman, make him the cutest that I've ever seen. Give him two lips like roses and glow. Then tell him that his lonesome nights are over. Sandman, I'm so alone. Ain't got nobody to call my own. Parade, all you needed were two things, a pet shop and lots of money. How much is that doggy in the window? The one with the raggedy tail. How much is that doggy in the window? Ruff, ruff. I do hope that doggy's for sale. Probably the man who gave us more beautiful songs on the hit parade was a beautiful singer. Bless his heart. Mona Lisa, Mona Lisa. You're just like the lady with the mystic smile. Men have brought many loves to your doorstep. It was the first time in the history that a performer had the privilege and the honor of singing her own number one hit. When they were hard to get, you wanted my kisses. When first we met, how you wanted my kisses. And the day as true as mine is hard to get. Now, I remember Snooky and I singing this song as an old lady and an old man, and his beard fell off and my wig fell off, and we ended up cackling this song. This old house once knew my children, this old house once rang with shouts, now that tremble came about the same. I need this house no longer, and I'm gonna need this house no more. Ain't got time to fix the shingles, ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to all the hinges, gotta mend the windowpane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer, he's getting ready to meet the same. And of course, probably the prettiest, the Spanish songs. Now the hacienda's dark, the town is sleeping. Time for weeping. Fire.
some chills. That was so pretty. Really nice.
Well, those were some of my favorites.
Wait, I gotta tell you, it's such a thrill for me just to be here with all of the hip parade as Eileen and Snooky and yourself. And it's just a thrill.
Well, Dick, if only Dorothy Collins could have been here.
Through the magic of television, here's Miss Dorothy Collins.
The only sad part of my touring around the country, because I've been loving this, is the fact that I can't be with you in person. But thank goodness we have tape, and I can say hi and send my love, and I can't wait to see the show on the air so I can see all of you.
Dorothy, when anyone ever refers to your hip parade, they immediately think of you, Dorothy Collins. Now, how long were you with the show?
It was from 1949. We did the four experimental shows, and then from 50 to 57. And then I did another year with Johnny Desmond.
Now, for the piece de resistance, Dorothy, how about favoring us with one of the hit songs that you sang on your hip parade back in the 50s?
And here's the medley. We put together a few of the songs. You know, I'm always being asked a question. Well, actually, two questions. The first one always is, whatever happened to Snooky Lanson? And Snooky, I'm glad you're answering that tonight for me. And the second one was, didn't you ever get tired of singing the same songs over and over again? And that answer is no. I loved it. I loved the show, and I loved singing the songs. And we put together a few of the songs that I did and enjoyed the most on the show. And maybe you remember some of them. I did 17 straight weeks in a row. No, I never got tired of it.
Corey, Tommy Leonetti, June Valli, and more scenes from Your Hit Parade.
Very nice to meet you finally. I've seen you so often on television. I'm a very big fan of yours. I always watch the show and I say to my daughter Clara, who's about 10, if I could only meet that man. He's so sweet and he's so kind. He's so gentle.
Oh, I have
so
gotten
nice
something out of this show.
Hard to work with. I'm just
thank
kidding.
It's nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Now, you joined the show Hit Parade with Tommy.
Yeah, we were a team. Yeah,
was that when they were all in color?
We were the first full season in color, yeah.
That was an exciting moment in American television.
Yes, it was. We went out to Brooklyn to film. Remember that time?
Sure.
And it was the opening show, and I was to do Tammy, first time in color, right? And they were going to do something very intricate and complicated with superimposing pictures upon pictures upon pictures. And we had 2 weeks of rehearsal. Usually you only have 1 week. We had 2 weeks because it was the premiere show. And nobody told me, but something was going amiss with my number. Well, they finally had to tell me, and guess what they did? At the end of dress rehearsal, 1 half hour before showtime, live, right? They said, Jill, don't panic because there are a couple of 50 million people watching you out there. He said, but we got to start from scratch with Tammy. So you go with the choreographer off to your little corner and restage. And I was so young and naive. Didn't panic. Oh, that's fine. Sure. Well, I have time for makeup. I
so
did.
30 minutes, you did
30
what?
Minutes. Restaged the number, got my makeup on, and got my hair done, and changed costume.
Oh, here's, if you watch very closely on monitor, something I think you had a little longer time to rehearse. Watch. Now, your little girl, I know Claire Michelle, that's
yes.
her name. She told me that you also made a movie. Was that before Hit Parade or after?
Right after the Hit Parade. Right after the Hit. You see, the Hit Parade, when you were on the Hit Parade, you became an instant star.
Star.
Yeah. So I got my first booking in Las Vegas. And after my 3 weeks appearance in Las Vegas, I flew out to Hollywood for the first time and did a movie. Oh,
what was it called?
Fun.
Did you play the lead?
I had my own trailer, my own dressing room. Oh, it was a terrible movie, but
what
who
was it called?
Cares? I meant Senior Prom.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear that.
Senior Prom.
Senior Prom,
right?
It's absolutely amazing.
They made me a redhead. And,
if I got them the material, would they make one for me, do you think? No, I'm joking. Listen, darling, would you...
You know, I didn't follow that.
Would you do me a favor?
What?
And not just me, all of the people that love the Hit Parade and are watching tonight. Would you sing a song for us now?
Sure.
All right.
Yeah.
Hop over there with that. And the song... Pretty song was Fascination, the pretty lady, Jill Corey.
It was fascination, I know. And it might have ended right there at the start. Just a passing glance, just a brief romance. And I might have gone on my way empty-hearted. It was fascination. Touched my hand, the next moment you kissed me. Fascination turned to love.
Thank you. Stay tuned. for more songs from your Hit Parade stars and meet Russell Arms and June Valli.
Your eyes don't let the moon break your heart. Love blooms at night, in daylight it dies. Don't let the stars get in your eyes. Oh, keep your heart for me, for someday I'll return, and you know you're the only one I'll ever love.
He is not just another pretty face, Russell Arms. Thank you.
Thank you.
Did that take you back a little?
I don't recognize those figures up there. Oh,
of course not, because you're much more mature now.
Of course, yes.
You were one of the originals, right?
Yeah, that's true. I came on kind of through the back door, however. I started doing commercials, and it was a general understudy for everybody. They was afraid Snooky'd get sick one day or something, you know, so they said, would you like to do that? And I said, sure, fine.
So you understudied for a while.
And at the end of one season, they allowed me to sing one song, just as a thank you for having been to every rehearsal and every show.
Oh, that's got to be murder.
Oh, it was.
All those rehearsals.
Very frustrating.
Why didn't you kill Snooky?
I thought of it. Yeah? And he thought of killing. Well, you know how that went. But at any rate.
You remember the song you sang?
Yeah, My Truly, Truly Fair.
Guy Mitchell song.
Right. Yeah. And they got a lot of fan mail over the summer, and they said, who was that? Because all of a sudden a stranger.
Oh, that's right. They'd never seen you before.
No. So, the next season, they said, let him sing once in a while. And so they had an extra one left over. Why, I got to sing it through that season. And the next year, I got promoted to be in the bullseye.
That's exciting. Right?
Oh, it sure was.
You did what, two songs a night?
Usually two, yeah.
Any panic? I know that that's the thing that people really don't understand. We can stop and start again with tape. Live, you know, as we're discussing tonight.
Exactly.
Give me a panic instance where you almost killed
yourself. Live shows, you know, you only had one shot at it. And then it was your whole week. If you blew it, that was it. One week I was singing a song called Allegheny Moon. And I was a scarecrow, of all things. And they had the thing, and I was up there in the scarecrow suit with a straw sticking out, and white gloves and the hat and the whole thing, and the scarecrow makeup. And during the dress, everything went fine.
Dress rehearsal.
I went back to my dressing room and kind of looked to see that the phony makeup was on. And I took off my gloves to do this, and I left them on my dressing table. So then I went back and got, I was all ready, prepared, standing up there. All of a sudden, I realized I didn't have my gloves. Now, instead of simply going ahead without the gloves, I ran all the way back to the dressing room, made a whole scene, got back on my thing, and I'm going, Allegheny. Total insanity.
Oh, you laughed.
Well, I saw Kenny of you on water skis, supposedly. Oh,
yes. I forget the song, but I was supposed to be water skiing. And I'm in shorts, you know, and holding the thing. And there's a stagehand lying on the floor. And they've got a screen in back of me.
That's
with
right,
a movie
everything
going.
Moving, yeah.
And I'm, you know, playing and I'm singing. And he's got a hose going with cold water spraying on me the whole time.
Well, the bad news is he's here again tonight. He has the hose, and I think I can hold him off long enough for you to sing us a song. Will you do that?
Very good if you hold him off.
Sure, we'll hold him off. The song is Valli on Many, Many Weeks, 1958, and the singer, who else? Mr. Russell Arms.
Valli, oh, cantare, oh, nel blu, dipinto di blu, felice di stare lassù.
Now, here's the hard part.
Penso che un sogno così non ritorni mai più. Mi dipingevo le mani da faccia di blu. Eat your heart out, Dina. Poi d'improvviso venivo dal vento rapito e cominciavo a volare nel cielo infinito. Feather, a
first year you were the understudy on the show.
Right.
Now we're going to put you all back together again. You're the three stars. Want you to sing a song. I think it was 12 weeks on the Hit Parade. The year was 1951. We're from a show called Call Me Madam. Mm-hmm. The song title was?
Mm-hmm. I'll play Ethel Merman.
You're all right. Just in
okay.
love.
That's
you're just in love?
You're just in love.
Nice hand, ladies.
Come on,
Ethel.
Singing and there's no one there.
Well, I was worried about you.
I smell blossoms, but the trees are bare.
It's just my perfume.
All day long I seem to walk on air. I wonder why.
I know.
I wonder why. I keep tossing in my sleep at night.
It's been something you ate.
And what's more, I've lost my appetite.
You're gonna fool me, Russ.
That used to twinkle in the sky are twinkling in your eyes. I wonder why.
Well, I'll tell you what, Wallace.
All right.
You don't need analyzing.
No.
It's not so very surprising
yeah.
that you feel very strange but nice.
Thank you.
I feel good.
Your heart goes pitter-patter. I know just what's the matter because I've been there once or twice.
Heard that about you.
Your
I keep tossing in my sleep at night.
Older,
and what's more, I've lost my appetite. Stars that used to twinkle in the sky are twinkling in your eyes. I wonder why. When I sing, we're just in
love. We'll be back with more entertainment from your Hit Parade stars when the entire gang meets June Valli and two surprise guests from behind the scenes of your Hit Parade. And now we're going to meet a couple of gentlemen behind the scenes. First of all, a gentleman who did the vocal arrangements and was in charge of the choir, made some of the greatest LPs that I got lucky with girls with. Will you say hello, please, to Mr. Ray Charles? In the last year of the Hit Parade, the gentleman whose task it was to find a new way each week to present, sort of write the situation where the song would be in. His gentleman, Mr. Buddy Arnold. Thank you, Buddy. And Buddy also wrote this show today, so you see, he's still making a nice buck off of the Hit Parade. You worked with some heavyweight people when you did that.
Well, we did the show, yes. We did the show in 1959, and the producer of the show is now the chief executive for West Coast Television of CBS, Mr. Perry Lafferty.
Now, Ray, your job every week was, I guess a song would be a hit.
Right.
Right? Was that at a meeting suddenly? How did you find out what songs were on the Hit Parade?
We would have a meeting, a lunch meeting on Monday, up at the agency, and about 12:30, the news would come. It's like the messenger from Garcia would
the
come.
List would
the
arrive.
List would arrive of what the show was going to be that week. The various sources, I guess, who collated the material, got it together, and we would get about 12:30 on Monday at the meeting, and they would say, you know, which were the seven songs. They had already chosen which two extras would be on. There were always seven survey songs and two Hit Parade extras.
Let me just ask Buddy one thing. That's got to be a tough job to present a song. Like now Ray said, after two or three weeks, you start then to musically, vocally change, make it original. Your job now, because the songs were presented literally. I'm going to sit right down and write myself a letter.
In some way, you would see somebody sitting at a desk and writing a letter.
Or in a jail or
exactly. jail. There would be a noose, a shadow of a noose on the wall, and somebody being led toward it as the singing Hang Down Your Head, Tom Dooley.
You know, everybody tries to analyze what happened to the Hit Parade.
Yeah, I mean,
but I
did
think
rock and roll? Was rock and roll?
It was more than rock and roll. I think it was just a revolution. It was a whole sociological change. That's a big word.
Yes.
We know what killed Hogan's heroes, word of mouth.
I think what... No, when I grew up, my pop songs were the same songs my folks had.
Uh-huh.
And I think it stayed that way up until the 50s, when Bill Haley, maybe, is the first one, Rock Around the Clock. All of a sudden, it was really not the song that mattered. Up to then, it had been, and anybody here can sing the song beautifully. All of a sudden, it became a cult of the performer.
The identification of the performer.
Yeah, and the records that came on the charts were put there by kids who didn't watch television. They bought records, and that still maintains
today.
We have the record charts mean nothing to television.
Music industry is a total separate industry. There could be someone today who'll sell 25 million records who's never been on the tube ever.
And of course.
Well, what happened was the song would get on because the record was there. But the people who were watching television really didn't care about those songs.
That was the start of rebellion at the time, too,
It was the rebellion, really.
Because the kids didn't want to watch what their parents had watched, listen to what their parents had listened to, dance to what they did.
They wanted their own identification.
They wanted something of their own. Therefore, the look of the hit parade had to be something different, and it just could not get along with the feeling of the music that was coming in.
They also wanted to hear the original version.
They wanted to hear the original version, right.
Yes.
So then maybe rock and roll has been bad-mouthed. It was the times that were changing.
Yeah, they all try to blame it on me, but it wasn't.
I'm sure. He doesn't go home. So that obviously these gentlemen worked hard. Their job was to present a song in a different way, and that's tough. Now, for instance, I'm going to show you a little clip of film. How many ways can you vocally and, you know, with scenic design, change a song like Get a Job, Sha Da Da Da?
Oh, no.
Please watch this. We would never get you out here, huh?
Oh, I knew it was going to come sooner or later, but I'm glad I'm here now.
Well, thank you for being honest, because that makes the party complete.
Oh, you know, and listening to all what they were saying, you know, in 1952, we had won the Peabody Award for all the different, you know, the way they interpret different songs.
Yeah.
And one song that I had to do, well, I think they were... It was going a little thin. I was lying on my back, and a magician was sawing me in half, and I was singing, If You Love Me Half as Much as I Do. Well, I tell you, that was no way to sing.
Any other really embarrassing moments, things that you remember, and you sort of are glad that it's live so they don't show it again?
Do you want to hear one?
Yeah.
I was playing a countess, and I was sitting in a horse and wagon, and there I was with a hoop skirt.
Oh.
And I was singing Auf Wiedersehen. Now I have to walk out of the wagon. The hoop skirt gets stuck, and there I was hanging from the wagon. I couldn't touch the floor, and I was singing Auf Wiedersehen. And the wagon's rolling out, and I'm hanging. And if there's anything more embarrassing than that... Boy, did
about
I get the
free
look
fall
when we looked at those shows on Thursday.
Beautiful. Could you do us a favor now?
What?
Would you please, and we'll all sit here just like we're in a nightclub watching you, do a medley for us?
I would love to.
Ladies and gentlemen, June Valli.
Here are some of the songs that you heard on your hit parade.
Oh, Wheel of Fortune. Thank you.
sail.
Hip parade. Ray, would you do the honors, please?
Tomorrow, late night action with Beretta. Tony boards a cross-country bus to follow a beautiful jewel thief, so don't miss Beretta tomorrow on ABC Late Night. What's it like to play host to the president? Find out when Good Morning America visits the home of the family that President Carter is visiting, the Deal family of Des Moines, Iowa. Good Morning America with host David Hartman tomorrow on most of these ABC stations.